exercise 3.4, sum number 1, subdivision 2, solve the equation x minus 4, x minus 7, x minus 2, x plus 1 is equal to 16. This one fourth root of the equation set. So first of all, very important steps is solution the given value first, x minus 4, x minus 7, x minus 2, x plus 1 is equal to 16. So is equal to 16. The constant of any two terms let us take adding or subtracting. The another two terms adding or subtracting, the answer is same. That is, two terms is multiple of the eligible. That is inset multiplication eligible. So the first one minus 4, this one minus 7, minus 11, remaining minus 2 plus 1. This is not eligible. So this is not eligible. This one first is not eligible. Then second is going to minus 4 minus 2 is equal to minus 6. So minus 4 minus 2 is equal to minus 6. This one minus 7. So this one plus 2 is minus 6. So this is minus 6. This is also minus 6. So the inside multiplication eligible term is x minus 4 and x minus 2. Next to x minus 7, next x plus 1 is equal to 16. So the first rearranging the given equation, x minus 4 into x minus 2 into x minus 7 into x plus 1 is equal to 16. Next to first two terms inside multiplication, next to second two terms is also inside multiplication. First two terms let us take, which implies that this one inside multiplication, x square minus 2x minus 4x, this one minus into minus plus 8. The first two terms inside multiplication completed. Is going to second two terms. So again x square plus x minus 7x minus 7 is equal to 16. Minus 7 is equal to 16. So next, which implies that x square minus this one 6x plus 8 into x square minus 6x minus 7, that is equal to 16. So the most important line, the first two term, the first two term is same. So we get the result is correct. So put the value of y is equal to x square minus 6x. The same process for this x is having 4 sums, having 5 sums. So one sum says sum is wrong. Example 2, again sum is wrong. Remaining x is 3 sums, the same procedure. That is an important point. That is an important area. So therefore y minus plus 8. Next, y minus 7 is equal to 16. So this one reducing the power. So this is the equation of x power 4, the fourth root of equation. This is the root of second. So quadratic equations. So this is also inside multiplication. Y square, the first one, minus 7y plus 8y, next minus 56 is equal to 16. So again y square minus plus y, next to minus 56 minus 16 is equal to 0. Next one y square plus y minus 72 is equal to 0. So this is the quadratic equations. We get the solution of two solutions. So therefore y square plus y minus 72 is equal to 0. So multiplication minus 72, addition is 1. So 9 8s are 72. Which one minus? So the large, so smallest number only minus. So y plus 9 into y minus 8 is equal to 0. So y plus 9 is equal to 0. Y minus 8 is equal to 0. So y is replaced by value. Put y already used. Y is equal to x square minus 6x. X square minus 6x. So therefore the first equation, x square minus 6x plus 9 is equal to 0. This is the first equation. Is going to second equation, x square minus 6x minus 8 is equal to 0. So these two equations we get the solution of two solutions. So that is the answer is completed. First one, multiplication is 9, addition is minus 6, minus 3, minus 3. So x minus 3 into x minus 3 is equal to 0, x minus 3 is equal to 0, x minus 3 is equal to 0. Then x is equal to 3, x is equal to 3. We get the result of first equation. Let's go into second equation. Second equation, multiplication 8, addition is 4. This is not eligible for direct factorize. It's going to formula x is equal to 1. Next to b is equal to minus 6, c is equal to minus 8. Next, x that is equal to minus b plus or minus root of b square minus 4ac the whole divided by 2a. So that x is equal to minus b, that is called 6 plus or minus root of 36, that is called minus 6 the whole square. Next one minus 4 into a value 1, next c value minus 8 whole divided by 2 into 1. So then x that is equal to 6 plus or minus root of 36, this one minus minus plus 32 the whole divided by 2. The next one x that is equal to 6 plus or minus root of 68 the whole divided by 2. So that is equal to 6 plus or minus root of 4 times of 17 whole divided by 2. 4 times of 17 is equal to 68. 4 is carrying root of 2. So x that is equal to 6 plus or minus 2 into root 17 the whole divided by 2. That is equal to 2 is a common value. The remaining value is 3 plus or minus root 17 the whole divided by 2. So we get the result 3 plus or minus root 17. So therefore the roots of the given equation is the first root x that is equal to 3 comma 3, next one 3 plus or minus root 17. We get the result. That's all.